Hello, I'm James Murphy, and welcome to part 2 of What's New Coming in Python 3.10. In the last video, I discussed everything relating to type hints. In this video, it's everything else. Most of what we'll cover in this video is more or less just quality of life improvements, but there are some new features. Okay, let's get started. In my video on data classes, the one thing that I said the data classes library is lacking is support for the slots feature. Well, data classes now support slots. Nice. They can also now be pretty printed. As far as quality of life improvements, here we go. First up is parenthesized context managers. You can now use parentheses to enclose context managers, which allows you to put them on multiple different lines if you so choose. Previously, you weren't able to do this because of limitations of the parser, but in Python 3.9, the parser was actually updated to a new kind of parser. The new parser is a little bit more robust from the old one, and it can now handle things like this that the old one couldn't. This is especially useful when you're using and capturing multiple different context managers. If you had to put all of these on the same line or use line continuations, this would be really annoying. The next quality of life update is a whole bunch of different better error messages. For instance, if you forget a closing brace, Python will now tell you that you didn't close the brace. I'm sure that veteran Python programmers are well aware of what kinds of error messages you might have gotten if you forgot to close a brace somewhere, but for new Python programmers, something like this can really make it easier to learn the language. It tells you exactly what went wrong. It can now also tell you about needing extra parentheses around generator expressions and arguments, and it can tell you if you forgot a colon, say, after an if statement. I've definitely done this one, forgetting to put parentheses around a tuple in a comprehension. The previous error message was not so helpful. It looks like this person, Pablo, contributed basically all of these better error messages, so thank you to Pablo. Did you forget a comma? Did you forget some parentheses? Did you have a dictionary key with no value? Did you use a single equal sign instead of two? I've never tried to do this, but apparently starred expressions are not allowed in F strings. Now I know. And the list keeps going. Better errors if your indentation is messed up. And did you mean suggestions for typos in attributes or in names? I think these better error messages are really going to help out newcomers. On the other hand, PEP 626 about precise line numbers is going to help veterans alike. Those of you that have spent enough time debugging may have noticed in the past that line numbers are not exactly right all the time. I'm not exactly sure what makes it happen, but it seems to crop up in multi-line comprehensions and pass statements. In any case, line numbers in debug statements are going to be more precise in Python 3.10. Here's a change that was really hidden in the details. Remember my video on how plus equals is the sharpest corner in Python? Well, apparently, power equals was a little bit sharper because there was a bug in its implementation. Power equals will now behave the same as all other augmented assignment operations like plus equals. And as long as we're down here, let's talk about PEP 618, adding a strict flag to the zip function. Now you can pass strict equals true to a zip in order to ensure that all of the iterables have the same length. If they don't, it'll raise an error. There are also some optimizations to existing features in the language. The most notable one is that they claim that constructing strings, bytes, and byte arrays is now 30 to 40% faster. I'm a little skeptical about that one. Do some performance tests and let me know what you find in the comments. The last two things that I wanted to talk about are two safety features that have been added to Python. Python now requires a recent version of OpenSSL. I think this is a good thing. I don't think you should be using any kind of out-of-date cryptography software. And the last thing that I wanted to mention was the new optional encoding warning. If you're reading or writing text files, you should pretty much always be using UTF-8. But in some operating systems, this is not the default, and it is therefore also not the default in Python. This has previously been a huge source of bugs where one person tries to write a file, gives it to someone on a USB stick who tries to read the file, and it doesn't work. You can now set this flag to true if you want a warning so that you can see all the places in your codebase where you don't specify an encoding or that you're using a binary format. Alright, that's pretty much the rest of the stuff that stood out to me on the changelog. If you haven't already, be sure to check out my video on structural pattern matching. That's really the big feature that was introduced in 3.10. Otherwise, of course, there's a huge amount of things that changed that I didn't talk about. Let me know what your favorite is in the comments. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.